very unique tree I am going to discuss is tamarix. Tamarix, commonly known as salt cedar, because it grows in the saline soils. It is salt tolerant species. It is also known as salt bush. Some are shrubs and some are medium-sized trees. Name tamarix has come from the Tamaris River in Spain. This is the tree which is also finds mention in the Bible. This was the tree which Abraham planted, and under its shade he preached sermons. This particular tree is known as Jabuka in Sanskrit, and from Jabuka in Dogri we call it as Jau. Another Artemisia species is also called as Jau, but this tamarix is different from Artemisia. Artemisia is from sunflower family bush, but Jau or tamarix has its own family called Tamaricaceae under the order Violales or Caryophyllales. In Urdu, it is also called as a frash. And this particular tamarix has about 56 species. There are two different types of genera in the family. One is called as true tamarisk, which is tamarix, and another is false tamarisk. False tamarisk is Myricaria. Both are seen in riverine habitats, but tamarix is more salt tolerant as compared to Myricaria. Tamarix is also found near the Dead Sea. The stamens are usually united in case of Myricaria, false tamarisk, whereas they are free. Stamens are free in case of tamarisk, salt cedar. This is found in Ladakh, Jammu, Kashmir, Afghanistan, Middle East, Central Asia, and it's also mentioned as Bible tree. Abraham planted it, rested under its shade. Its leaves are tiny and they look like juniper or thusa, Thusa plicata. So it is called salt cedar. A false tamarisk Myricaria. We have two, three species. One is Myricaria germanica, which we see in the Kishanganga River, sandy tracts, also seen in Pahalgam, also in Nubra Valley. Another species which we see in India is Myricaria elegans, even in Ladakh and Pahalgam. Here the leaves are more than 5 millimeter. They approach 1 or even exceed the 1 centimeter in length in case of Myricaria elegans. But the leaves are much smaller, half centimeter or even less in case of Myricaria germanica or Myricaria squamosa. And Myricarias are called as ombu or humbu in Ladakhi language. Whereas the tamarix species is called as lal jhau or jhau in Jammu, and it has the jhabuka Sanskrit name and also known as frash. This tamarix is named after the Tamaris River, which is found in Spain. There are both evergreen species as well as deciduous species. Tamarix aphylla, which grows very tall tree, 15 to 18 meter tall, which is found in Egypt, Arabian Peninsula, India, Pakistan. It is also known as Tamarix aphylla. It is evergreen, also known as ethel pine. From a distance, it looks like Casuarina. It is also known as ethel tamarisk. And most of the tamarisk species, they flower during spring and summer. But Tamarix aphylla flowers during winter time. And likewise, we have another deciduous species also. For example, Tamarix tetrandra, which is also known as four stamen tamarix. It has the branches are arching, and this is deciduous. We have even the folklore use of its medicinal uses of the tamarix species. They are useful in wound healing, for the treatment of cuts, for the treatment of bleeding disorders, rectal bleeding, even in piles, constipation, gastric, intestinal, parasitic infestation. We have many species, 56 or so species under Tamarix and about 10 species under Myricaria. 2-3 species under Myricaria are reported from Jammu and Kashmir. Very ornamental species which is reported from Ladakh is Tamarix ramosissima. It has very pink, large plume-like leaves and flowers, and it is very elegant, but leaves are tiny and it grows in the cold desert area. It is also reported that most of the tamarix species, they were used by Sakas for the bow making. It is also used in combating the desertification, especially in China. Tamarix ramosissima, which is ornamental, but it has gone invasive in America, and this is the deciduous species with arching branches. Another species is Tamarix gallica. This is also known as French tamarisk, or also known as the manna plant. So it has some kind of association for the extraction of manna plant, which is a food product. This particular gallica is also found in Saudi Arabia, Mediterranean location. Its branches are fragile, they fall off during winter. Flowers are hermaphrodite. Both male and female parts are found in the same flower. And it is said that Abraham planted this particular plant, which is called as Tamarix gallica, also known as Shakar Gaj or Sya Gaj. And this is reported to be used in the preparation of a Persian desert, which is called as Gaj, some delicacy. It is also useful in combating the rheumatism, diarrhea, and it is medicinal. Even in the book of Genesis, it has been mentioned as the tree planted by the Abraham. In Australia, the Tamarix aphylla has gone invasive, and it has replaced even eucalyptus plants in some locations. Whereas Tamarix aphylla is also seen in North America, but it is not that much invasive, as is the ramosissima. Tamarix ramosissima has gone invasive in America. Tamarix dioica, which we usually find, that is dioecious. Male and female flowers are separate plants, and it is known as Nona Jhau in Sundarbans, Nona Gach in Bengal, Ghaj in Pakistan, Khagal is another popular name. Its racemes are pink purple, and this plant, Tamarix dioica, grows in association with babool, Bacillia nilotica, pilu, Salvadora persica, and is reported antifungal. And another species which is reported from Africa is Tamarix nilotica, also known as Nile tamarisk. It is also reported from Middle East. It is useful in combating the desertification, and it is used in dune stabilization. It is also found in Palestine. And Tamarix nilotica is because of the Nile River Valley. And this particular Tamarix grows in association with plants like camel thorn, alagi, marorum, and is having the 5 sepals and 5 petals. Even the stamens are 5, and a raceme of flowers is 5 to 10 centimeter long. Another species which is seen in China is Tamarix pentendra or Tamarix chinensis. It is also known as 5 stamen tamarix, as the flower has 5 stamens. It is found in China, Korea, and also useful in honey, apiary, beekeeping. and is reported to be used by the birds for nesting. Tamarix hispida, reported from Central Asia, is also known as Kashgar tamarisk. And this is again like Tamarix aphylla. It is also autumn flowering. Another species which we usually find in Kashmir, grown in parks and gardens, is Tamarix parviflora, that is small flowering tamarisk. Here, in one flower, the petals are four. Another species reported from Senegal and Cape Verde and South Africa is Tamarix senegalensis, also popularly known as tarafe. So we see Tamarix gallica also finds use as laxative. It is useful for as a hepatoprotective. It is useful in rheumatic pains and even in combating the bacterial and viral infections. In Tamarix, stipules are not there. They are absent and leaves are highly reduced. So the branches are very slender and look like pines or thusa. So they are known as salt cedars. In Jammu and Kashmir, we have both Tamarix as well as Myricaria. In Kandy belt of Jammu, we find Tamarix but not Myricaria. Myricaria is found in the temperate locations like Kashmir, Pahalgam, Gurez, or even in cold desert of Ladakh. These species are also reported to be useful in combating the jaundice problem, especially in Spain. And its products, its juice or its honey is also high quality honey. And its unique firefighting, fire resistant and drought resistant nature also recommends as a species useful in sand dune stabilization, in combating desertification and introducing this tree in the shelter belts as windbreaks in the storming deserts. So this particular flower is also having the ornamental value and is useful for introduction even in parks and gardens.